The functional assessment-based intervention model employs a systematic approach to designing, implementing, and evaluating functional assessment-based procedures developed by Umbright, Farrow, Leopsen, and Lane, 2007. In previous videos, we have worked through step one, identifying students who need a FABI. Step two, conducting the functional assessment, where we discuss how to discover the reasons why challenging behaviors occur, the function. In step three, collecting baseline data, we discuss different behavior measurement recording and baseline procedures for how to measure present levels before beginning the intervention. In the previous step, step four, designing the intervention, we discuss how to select and develop an appropriate intervention method using the function-based intervention decision model, which includes antecedent adjustments, shifts in reinforcement contingencies, and extinction components. This video introduces you to step five, testing the intervention. In step five, teams implement and evaluate the intervention using three essential indicators of trustworthiness to draw accurate conclusions regarding the intervention outcome. For this, teams are encouraged to ask and answer three questions. Was the intervention implemented as planned, which is looking at treatment integrity? Was a functional relation established between the introduction of the intervention and changes in student behavior, and did these outcomes generalize or maintain? In other words, were student outcomes monitored to determine a functional relation? And what did stakeholders, such as teachers, parents, and students, think about the social significance of the intervention goals, the social acceptability of the intervention procedures, and anticipated effects of the intervention after concluding the intervention, which is looking at social validity? To answer these three questions, teams complete information by assessing treatment integrity, using a single case research design, such as an ABAB withdrawal, changing criterion, or multiple baseline design, to examine student performance while measuring behavior using a valid measurement system and administering social validity surveys prior to and at the conclusion of the intervention to examine stakeholders' views. Teams follow single case design methodology to guide when to introduce, withdraw, or change conditions by employing visual analysis. This involves graphing student performance data, which can be done using Excel or other similar programs. Once graphed, student performance is analyzed using traditional visual inspection techniques, such as stability, level, and trend. As these data are collected, school-based teams monitor and evaluate the effectiveness of the intervention with careful considerations towards treatment integrity, shifts in student behavior when the intervention is and is not in place, and the social validity of stakeholders prior to the start and at the conclusion of the intervention. This concludes the final step in the FABI process, step five, testing the intervention. In these videos, we learned step one, identifying a student in need of a FABI, step two, conducting the functional assessment, step three, collecting baseline data, step four, designing the intervention, and step five, testing the intervention. We wish you every success as you move forward with designing, implementing, and evaluating functional assessment-based interventions. To learn more about functional assessment-based interventions, you may also review Applied Behavior Analysis, 2nd edition, by Cooper, Heron, and Heward, 2007, and Functional Behavior Assessment and Function-Based Intervention, an Effective Practical Approach by Umbright, Farrow, Leopsen, and Lane, 2007.